Greetings, humans. Greetings, and welcome back to another fun-filled episode. Bear here, 29-year veteran of the woods of today. Today we've got another package here. You know, Bear was out in the woods, you know, foraging for food, and I saw the postman come by. Actually, you know what? Actually heard the postman come by. The muffler or something like that was a little bit off, so could hear the jeep coming from probably like a mile away or something like that. So Bear was ready, and right in front of little Timmy McTimerson's house to surprise the postman there. And of course, you know, the postman drops this package here, so Bear's gonna open it up for you good people here. For you good people. Yes indeed. Okay, well, Bear's probably can kind of figure out, can kind of figure out what's inside, and, you know, we've already kind of, we've actually been doing quite a many, box openings as it is, so, what Bear's gonna do is kind of combine the box open that we have here with, you know, some little announcements that, that Bear has for the channel that he has here, so, hey, stay tuned for those great announcements there, but, hey, you know, enough jibber-jabber here, let's go ahead and, you know, get to the main course here. Let's go ahead and open up this package here, and, as you can see there, you know, the postman drops it, so, had a little bit of damage, but, hey, you shouldn't have seen the postman, ha 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 ha, yes, indeed. Okay, alright, let's get this open with, Bear remembers it. It's just a simple tab here. Not as bad as the tape. You know, the tape. And the postman. Tape. Two nemesis of Bear. But, go ahead and open this up here. Pretty easy. Pretty easy to get it open here. Get that out of the way. Get that out of the way, and, there we go. Get it open there for you good people. Shake it out, and, nothing much. Okay, there we go. All right, and look at there. We've got another cyber frog. Another cyber frog for you good people. You know, and if you haven't checked out Bear's where is it here? Bear's other box opening. He had the Salamandroid box opening. Do check that out. And, some good stuff. But what we got here is a little team-up cover. So, you know, Bear thought, you know, been doing quite a number of these box opens already. And I've already did Cyber Frog here already. But, you know what, some of you had not got this cover just yet. So, hey, you know, just wanted to show it off for you good folks here. And, of course, we also got, with the other stuff there as well. All the other goodies, but, you know, the big thing was the ash cans here. Yes, indeed. So, you know, Bear did a, quick run through of all this stuff when he did the first box opening, and actually, as a matter of fact, let's just go ahead and get into it. We've already got it open here. Nice little sticker there, but, you know, Bear is actually, right in the middle of actually doing a review of, Cyber Frog here, as well as Jawbreakers, yes, indeed, your boy Zach, so, one of the things that, that Bear's trying to get back into is, doing the reviews for these good comic books here, so, you know, trying to get back into that, but, you know, Bear's been busy. Bear's actually been busy these past couple weeks, actually, you know, trying to develop, a nice little stage, a nice little place where we can do all that stuff, and, you know, Bear wasn't actually planning on doing a box opening today, but, you know, got this in, so, hey, hadn't made a video in quite a while, so, figured go ahead and do that, do a couple announcements there as well, so, you know, we're trying to put up fire on the screen, you know, what Bear's gonna be doing, so, as soon as we get all that stuff, built up and taken care of, there goes the construction workers again, so, Bear's got a nice little spot out in the woods, but, you know, he's been, you know, hammering and, you know, sawing and all this other stuff to get it nice and ready for you folks, so, hey, stay tuned with Bear's channel, stay tuned with Bear's channel. You know what? If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and consider subscribing. Hit that thumbs up for Bear. Hit that thumbs up because, you know, Bear's thumb right there. Claws aren't what they used to be. Go ahead and hit that thumbs up for Bear because we're going to be getting back into some reviews for good old Cyberfrog here. Oh, man. This Cyberfrog review. Oh, it's going to be huge. It's already up to, Bear gotten it up to like 25, 30 pages already. Bear had a lot to say. Very voluminous. Very voluminous of what Bear was trying to say. And, had to cut some stuff out there just a little bit. So, maybe try to put a little bit of that here. Maybe in this video here. But, one of the things actually Bear cut out. One of the things Bear cut out, it's not a make or break thing, but one of the things Bear noticed actually was the packaging here. Let Bear show you here. Bear with Bear. Don't normally try to compare the comics to one another, but kind of has a helpful way of getting the information across. So, what we have here is the box for good old Battle Made in Knucklebomb. Bear approved Battle Made in Knucklebomb here. As you can see, there it is. There's Battle Made in. Yes, indeed. Best comic in comics. Best comic, even better than Cyberfrog. And Bear will try and get into that a little bit here, but one of the things that Bear noticed. Battle Maiden made about, I believe it was like, about 48,000, somewhere right around there. A little less than 50,000 for Cyberfrog, for Battle Maiden that it made. Meanwhile, Cyberfrog made, it's about $1 million or so, give or take just a little bit. Depends on how you count the campaigns, but, that number's been thrown around out there, so Bear's just gonna go with it. Call it about $1 million for Cyberfrog, so... You know, one of the things that, you're getting $1 million for a campaign, so, figured, hey, you know, might spend a little bit, make it real nice, real fancy, one of the other, again, not to compare, no, but, one of the other box openings that Bear did was Earthworm Jim, that's right, so, very elaborate packaging, very nice, box was almost a piece of artwork itself, so, coming to this $1 million campaign here, it's kind of a plain Jane mailer there. You can see inside, it's just got the one little piece of cardboard in there to keep it from being bent. Bear likes to bend things. Well, you compare that envelope with, something that, Battle Maiden came in. So this is a Gemini mailer, so you can see right there, comics inside there. Tough to bend. But, one of the things that Kyung Lee did with, like, a fraction of what Cyberfrog made was, decided to put it in the nice box, but also had the beautiful little stickers here. And, actually, Bear is using these Gemini mailers to hold some of the comic books in. So, when they come in nice little packages like this, Bear likes to keep them. So, open it up, has the Gemini mailer in there. So that was one of the things that Bear took a look at, there's Battle Maiden. Now let's get it down. There we go. That was one of the reasons that Bear, really likes Battle Maiden here, over the Cyberfrog. Now let's get to this out of the way. A little bit over the Cyberfrog here. A number of different things, but, just simple things like that, like the packaging that it comes in. Not that it's a deal breaker or anything like that, but Bear would have liked to have seen a little bit more of a care in the packaging. You know, especially when he's chasing the postman away. Ripping flesh from bone, and packages go everywhere, and wants to have a little bit more sturdiness with the Gemini mailer. So. Not to get into the whole review here, but, simple things like that, one of the things that Bear noticed with Cyberfrog, it was a good story. It was a good story, but it was broken up a lot. So one of the reasons that the ash cans were kind of important here was because they filled in. They filled in a lot of information. So, for example, this one, this Cyberfrog here, this ashcan had the these claws are what they used to be. Aren't what they used to be. Can't just get to a single page here. There we go. So it kind of more or less tells the story there. It actually kind of goes in between chapters, parts. Goes between the parts in the book here. You know, kind of gets in between. Fills in a little bit more information. But, Bear would have liked to have seen some of the information here in the ash cans actually in the book here. Actually in the book of Cyberfrog here. So, some things like that. Some minor things like that a lot of the things that Cyberfrog came out with, it's the greatest ever, rah, 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 rah. A couple things like that, it kind of gnaws away at it, where, good old Battle Maiden here, good old Battle Maiden, still number one, although let me tell you, Jawbreakers, I've been reading through Jawbreakers, haven't gotten to the review yet, but, that's good, between Jawbreakers and Battle Maiden, that's a close match, but, anyways, just very briefly, just wanted to talk about, some of the things that Bear didn't have in the Cyberfrog review. 20, 25 pages, 30 pages, whatever it is, it's going to be huge. It's going to be huge, so I do encourage you to stick around for the Cyberfrog thing. Just another thing, real briefly here, and it's not a deal breaker. Let me put Battle Maiden up there. Put it up there and this is what's called chromium color. Chromium color. So as you can see, it's got the nice little reflection there too, but one of the things that Bear had a problem with was how this thing flexes. The doesn't quite stick to the book here. The cover kind of bows out. I don't know if we can tell. Not getting a very good look. There we go. This cover here kind of bows out, so it doesn't really sit flat. There we go. Doesn't really sit flat. Not sure if that's a cover issue or if it's actually a book issue, but just to kind of show you the difference. Both of these books are stapled together. Both of them are stapled together. But as you can see, let's put it up here together. Let's try and do a comparison here. As you can see, the Battle Maiden is much more flush, whereas the Cyberfrog kind of has this cover that kind of just bows out a little bit. There we go. So you can just kind of tell that. So, it wasn't a major thing, but it does kind of stick out a little bit. And, when you're reading it there, the foil kind of, I don't want to say gets in the way, but, it does stick out. Then it is noticeable. You know, a lot of the books, they come in square bound. This one was staple, but also Battle Maiden here, but sits much more flat than the chromium cover. But Bear's happy to see that the regular cover here, the team up cover, it's pretty flat. So if you just got the team up cover, that's not bad. Got a little bend in the middle, but that's not bad. Not bad at all. So there's that one. There's the chromium cover. Anyways, just a couple minor things that, Bear wanted to give Cyberfrog a really great review. And, just a couple of these minor things that are kind of edging away from, really good classics like our good friend here, Battle Maiden Knucklebomb. Which, by the way, Bear made a video the other day. Bear made a video the other day about Battle Maiden. It was supposed to be going out of the Indiegogo, but Kyung Lee went ahead and extended it. It's actually the first version here. It's on a different cover with a different paper stock here, but still worth your effort. I believe it's $15, so best deal in Comics Gate, in Bear's opinion. So do check out Battle Maiden if you haven't already. Kevin, not really. You see, actually, the quality of it. See the quality of it, and check out the review. So anyways, just a couple of things like that that, you know, Bear wanted to get out of the way there. You know, a couple of things that won't make it into the review of Cyberfrog here, but, you know, Bear's working hard on that. Working hard on a review of Cyberfrog. Working on a hard review of Jawbreakers. Oh gosh, what's next? Zombie Samba, Black and White, oh gosh, Bear's missing a couple, but we're gonna be starting to get back into the reviews here. Get back into it. Done plenty of box openings here, and Bear appreciates many of you sticking around with Bear as he does these box openings, and you know, showing them to you good people. But bigger things are coming. Bigger things are coming. You just wait. Just wait, and you'll see what Bear has in his claws here. Okay, all right, yes, Dave. Well, hey, once again, Bear appreciates you checking out the video. Do consider subscribing and hit that thumbs up button for Bear. Ring that bell for notification as well. But, hey, until next time, Bear's gotta head back into the woods, so, you know, until next time, he's gonna head out, so, Humans, thank you for watching this video. If you wish to have more, please like and subscribe. And don't forget that bell for notification. It would please Bear very much. You don't want to see Bear bad, do you?